everyone, and welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to be continuing on with this Australian Shepherd. So off camera, I added in this little section here. I just followed the same steps as I did in the ear and the rest of the dog. So I'm just working on the fur around the edge of the face, which is a little bit blurred and not in focus, so we're trying to get that type of look today. To get that, I'm not going to do as much detail as I normally do, so I did a base layer of warm gray 1, and I'm going in now with ivory just over all of that. I'm using the side of my pencil back and forth just to fill in the tooth of the paper a little bit more. I hope you are all doing well today. All right. Now that that is done, I'm going to go in with my beige red and cinnamon after that. So starting with beige red, I'm actually just going to put this down on the very tips of the fur. Again, I'm not worried about detail here. Fur has a little bit of a lift to it, so I'm going to try and get that. And I'm also going to put the beige red into the puppy's face where I stop. Just a little bit, help blend everything together smoothly. Now going in with cinnamon, I'm gonna just angle it this way. So I'm going to just kind of use the flicking motion, and I'm kind of doing it upwards, so starting at the base, flicking up. Rotating my pencil every once in a while, and I'll add a little bit down here. Going back up here, gonna add some more. Go with my terracotta. in the darker areas of the fur. I'm going to add a little bit of nougat just in a few areas that I can see that are darker. I'm going to add a little bit more this spot here. Going in with burnt sienna next. I'm just putting down burnt sienna where I think it needs to go, like in this section right here. A little bit up here as well. I'm gonna connect some of these fur lines together. I'm gonna go back in with my beige red just a little bit. Just kind of blend all these colors together. Going back in with my ivory. Over all of that with terracotta. Just want to add a little bit more of this in some places. So there's some white behind this. So what I'm just going to do is take my warm gray one and just put it behind. And also bring it into the fur that I just put down. down. Just the edges of the fur that I put down. And I'm not using a heavy touch here. I'm barely touching the paper while doing this. Bring it up a bit too. And then after that, I'm going in with, where is the color? Cold gray too. Cold gray too. And this is just going around the edge of where the brown meets the white. To kind of give it like a little shadow effect. Rotating my pencil every once in a while again to keep that tip nice and sharp. And I'm going to leave it like that for now. Actually, what I'm going to do is with burnt sienna, I've noticed there's just a little bit of a peak here. So burnt sienna going in. Just going to add just a tiny little triangle here by the looks of it. Bring it out a little bit here as well. My dark sepia. Go in and just add slight detail in this section. That right here needs to just be a tad bit darker. So with dark sepia, I'm just gonna add little flicks in here. And then we're gonna actually bring it down slightly. Same with around the nose as well, where the white meets the color. This section just needs a little bit more darker details. There. I'm gonna add a little bit more some terracotta into here as well. Just over what I put down. And back out here too. Just help blend everything. everything together. Not using a hard pressure, very, very light touch. Okay. Make that less pointy. Okay, let's see. All right, we're going to try and do the dog's nose. So I'm going to lightly remove the line, outer line of the dog's nose. I'm going to go in with warm gray 1. And I'm going to put that line kind of back in smoothly. And for this, I'm just doing back and forth and little circles. Okay. Next, what I'm going to do is get rid of these lines here. I'm going to take my nail dotting tool and I'm going to some details that I can see. I'm going to go over that with a little bit of white. And then I have my light ultramarine. And we'll just lightly put that in and around the nose. This reflection is on the blue side, so that will help. And then I'm going to go back in with my warm gray 1 and just map out where the pink meets the little darker spot of the nose. Okay, so after that is all said and done, I'm going to go with sepia. I'm going to sharpen it up a bit. Nice sharp point. So I'm actually going to go in and round the nostrils here with my sepia. Just kind of map in that, and then bring it down and kind of up and around. So okay. I'm going back over what I just put down in certain areas because I know these areas are actually going to stay dark. So over here, for example, is going to be darker, and this corner here is going to be darker, and right there as well. And then I'm going to put a little bit in the line. And over here as well. A little bit of details here. I can bring this up here because this is actually on the darker side, it's not pink. And then I can bring it down. And the same on this side as well. Details here. And I'm actually going to lightly put it over top of the gray that I just put down. I'm just using small circular motions for this. Don't know how I feel about that. Taking sepia and flicking it into the fur that's around the nose slightly. Taking it and flicking it into the nose a little bit. Around the nose. A little funny right now. That is okay. Okay. So I'm taking white. What I'm going to do with white is I'm actually going to put this down first in the areas that I can see that are very light pink or skin tone. Like right around here. And think I can bring this up a bit more. Yeah, that works. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do is go in with my cold gray one and put that down in the darker areas of the nose, just in the pink spot right now. I'm also putting it over the dark sepia. Help everything blend in together right here as well. And I'm using small circles. Next, I'm going in with my beige red. So, going in with beige red, light touch. I'm not putting a lot of pressure down, and I'm just putting this down in the areas that are pink. Again, very, very light. Very, very light, circular motion, like very light. Bring it up, like very light, like you can barely see that I'm putting anything down. Circles. Next, I'm going to go in with cinnamon, and cinnamon is just going to go in the shadow areas after I sharpen my pencil. Shadowed areas, so a little bit here, again, tiny little circle. Putting it into the sepia. Rotate my page here so I can get a good angle on it. So with this part of the nose, I'm actually kind of doing little circles and flicks to give the impression that some fur is kind of shading over the nose. Okay. circles into this section of the nose here. Okay. I'm going to put it here as well. I'm bringing it into the dark sepia. Tad bit down here. Okay. So I've got to add a little bit more of a shadow right here. Same with the top of the nose. Grab another color, hold on. Going in with light magenta. I'm gonna add a little bit of a pink tone to this nose. So I'm adding light magenta just a little bit in the darker areas and just overlapping tiny little bit into the lighter areas of the where I put down beige red. So I'm going to add a little bit of warm gray 3 just here. Looking funny. Okay, so with cold gray 1 now, I'm actually gonna go in this area with it. Inside the nostril over there. Around the blue. cold gray to in the darker areas. Kind of using a medium pressure here. Cold gray 3 next. Add that here. Again, small circles. Cold gray 3 is just helping me add a little bit more detail into the dog's nose. Cold gray 6 next. Payne's Gray. Going in with Payne's Gray. Adding Payne's Gray into the areas that I can see are the darkest. Add a little bit of purple in there, so I'm going in with that manganese violet. Just gonna add a tiny little bit of purple in this nose. Especially in the nostrils, around the edges. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to flatten this up a bit with the purple. Bring it around. Adding some shadows. Adding some loose hair shadows. And over here as well, adding some purple shadow in here. Well, say hello to my assistant. A little bit more blue needs to be added just here. And then Cold Gray 3. I'm gonna add it a little bit up here. Nose is gonna look a little funny right now just because I haven't added the fur around the tip or the edge, I should say, the edge of the nose. Even though it's a pink nose, purples and grays can definitely help add details, add depth to it. So I've lost the nostrils just a tad bit, so with my sepia, I'm going to go back in with a hard pressure, just add that back. Actually gonna bring it up just a little bit more here as well. Using not like a very, very heavy hand, but definitely a heavier pressure than I was in the beginning. And same with over here. And just here too. This needs to be a little bit darker. Okay, so I'm going to go in now with black. Definitely darken up a few spots in here. gonna go in with white a bit and just blend things together. Line up a few areas here. So, I hope you enjoyed the next part of the video of doing the dog's nose. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this video helps you out if you are doing the draw along with me. So here's a close-up of the nose. If I can get my camera to focus, there we go. Of the fur over here as well. So, thanks so much for watching, you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!